Hello, this is Matthias. Today I'm going to show you two cool tricks to solve this Power Query challenge from Excel BI, where we do have to add a number of rows between each entry. So first of all, I'm going to show you what this problem is about. So for example here, the first row, there is a 3 written here. And that means 3 rows have to be entered. Next one here shows a 2, means 2 rows have to be entered below. Then there is a 0, means no row to be entered below. There is a 9, means 9 rows below. And if you see here, yes, these are 9 rows. So the problem itself is easily described, but how to solve it? Well, one approach would be to apply these two tricks. First one for adding new rows to the table. And actually this is about creating dynamic lists. So you can use this for other applications as well, this dynamic list creation. Then the second issue is making sure that these rows below are empty. And here, I'm going to show you here a trick which you can find loads of application. It's very versatile. And I'm going to show you also the very first time I use this. So it's very useful. For real world data applications. Okay, so let's go to the table. It's already with Control T. Turn to a table called Add Blank Rows. So I can go to the Data tab and import directly from Table Range to the Power Query Editor. I'll make this a bit bigger and open the formula bar. First thing, to get that list, we add a column, a custom column, and that list will start with 0 and will go to number. So that's very easy. But the result is a dynamic list. So here we have 4 entries from 0 to 3. And the second one here has 3 entries from 0 to 2. So that's very good. You can use it in many cases, this technique. Now let's just expand this. Expand to new rows. There we are. We have now added the required number of rows. There's only one problem. These rows are not empty. So how to deal with this? So one approach is to replace. So for example, well, there are many entries here. Let's go here and replace values. Let's take A for an example, and the second one we leave empty. Yeah, so all A's are gone. That's not what we want. We want to keep the first A and get rid of the I's below the first A. And then we also want to deal with all the other entries. So it means we have to deal with these with the text here. So A obviously has to go out, and we want to deal with all of the entries, means we go here for each data. So that's already something. Obviously, we don't just want to get rid of all of them. We have to differentiate, and we introduce here an if. So if custom is 0, Then we go for data. Else. For bank. So that's good. That's exactly what we wanted. The only problem is we have to do it once more for the number column. And if you have more than just two columns, for example, you have 20 or more columns, then this is not an option. So let's go for a more generic approach. So in order to build this generic approach, let's have a look what happens in this replace value function. So there are three variables to consider. First of all, there is the data column. So these are all entries in this column. Let's call this A, the first variable. And then there is a second variable. The second portion is this one here. What do we want to replace? And C, the third portion is with what do we want to replace it? So let's get rid of this step completely and rebuild more generic. So let's mark all columns we want to replace upon. In this case, it's only two, but it could be more. So all marked, just right mouse, replace values. This time we just leave it empty. Now we got the structure that we need. So we have here the column names. This is A. Then we have here nothing for B. Okay. And C is also empty right now. So C we're going to replace with each. And here we go for custom. And we are going to build our own replacer function. And that's called, well, the variables are A, comma, B, comma, C. And we are free to build it the way we want it. But first, let's test whether I set it correctly. So now let's go here for A. A, I said, were the data from the columns. Yes. B, I said, was what was written here. Now let's go for B, and it's empty. So that matches too. And now let's test C. And no surprise, this is always the custom entry. So, how to build that function now? Yes, we had an if condition before, so we will go for an if again. If C equals zero, then A else we go for. That's exactly what we wanted. It's a great function because you can adapt it exactly to your needs. You will find lots of applications for it. And I'm going to show you afterwards the one where I came across it the first time. But first, let's get rid of the custom column. We'll keep only the data column and the number column. And then we close and load to H1. So that's table on existing worksheet H1. And let's have a look. Yes, that's precisely the way we want to have it. And I said, this is, well, very, very useful. Let's have a look at another example. And also we will see here that the function can be adapted, so according to your needs. So what you see here is a first case. I had to adjust many columns with a factor to make them match some reporting figures. So this were the awarded figures which were reported, and I had originally planned figures split for many regions, and I had to apply a factor to them that they then matched the reported figures. So here you see the figures were applied, and I used exactly the same technique but adapted here the function. The replacer function obviously has again the three variables A, B, C, but the function was the value from the column A times C, the value from the factor column. You see, it's easy to adapt. You could apply this for other operators, divide, add, subtract, whatever you want. And I hope you will find lots of instances where you can apply it to your own work. Hope you learned something. Until the next time, thanks.